Apple AI.
Welcome back.
Apple.
Oh.
Just totally say welcome back.
Oh God. Oh,
Apple
rough,
AI.
huh? We're a little rusty.
Apple investing into AI, as well as NVIDIA, China taking over the EV market in Mexico, and
Meta kicking ass, fucking TikTok interfaces you, and lots of other stuff.
Rick
Welcome
and
back to Rick
Bond,
and Bond.
your boys are here, baby.
Save me. I'm a big dog. Look who I am. I got a bad, bad, bad bitch. Some bands. I'm on top floor. Save me. I'm in cocky. I can't feel nothing. I'm a big dog. I can fuck a bitch out of France.
October 2022. One, Ricker and Bond told you to invest in their social token, jokingly, but it was like, hey, we literally said this is Amazon when Amazon sold books, and it's been about 2 years since that. So what's up?
Yeah, we just got back from vacation after spending all of our money from the token.
We did low key call the bottom of a 2 year cycle. It was I would share my screen, but it was, yeah, the bottom of every market. If we invested everything in that, we'd be a little bit richer.
October 2022. Was that the last episode?
Yeah, it was. That's why I have it freaking pulled up.
Fuck.
I listened to the last I listened to the very end of it, and there's tr first of all, Anchor is now completely Spotify.
Yeah.
Didn't know that till recently. AI exists now.
Damn, we literally stopped like right when AI started,
We've had
like.
a couple of bad timings with recordings of content. We just missed
That's
TikTok. We
crazy.
just missed AI. But there's
Just like
nothing like getting back at the very
just getting back in raw.
Nothing like
Just like
grinding at the top, dude.
no Vaseline, just come back like nothing,
It's
like
all for
nothing
Peter,
ever
man.
happened.
Peter, we've been waiting for you.
Oh, Jesus Christ, forgot about that guy.
Peter's
What the
happy.
fuck?
Everybody's happy.
I feel like I just took a really long nap and just woke up. Woke up like 50 pounds more muscle.
I remember Saint Lucia exists. Save Me by Future, it was a 2019 album, and it was great and it was amazing. And then, like, I was like a sleeper cell and like in like a transformer. I heard what?
The biggest hip hop beef of the decade. Like, just skipped over it.
We didn't need
We
it.
could have been covering that in real time.
It was pretty. That's also dead now. More than a decade. That was more than like, I guess Jay-Z and what. You have your decade beefs.
That's crazy.
AI existed, just missed that. Then
Crypto came
went.
back a couple times. I don't even know how many times.
Came and went. It does what it does.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
Missed NVIDIA.
God, I was such a young man back then.
I
Did we ever talk about NVIDIA before? Like,
think maybe
ever? I doubt it.
once, dude. Let me see. We are integrated into ChatGPT, by the way. It thinks my name is Adam Ricker and your name is Bond Jin.
Oh, man. ChatGPT. I can't wait to talk about that. Have you ever heard of it? Brand new.
Apparently, according to some sources, the Ricker and Bond podcast recently did discuss NVIDIA. We're up to date on everything. And this is apparently we discussed
Yeah.
it on August 23rd, 2024, which doesn't seem to be right, ChatGPT.
Huh.
So how
Interesting.
was
It was good.
your day, dude?
What did I do today? I went to the gym.
We're back at it. We're back
yeah,
at it. He's just like,
went to the gym, made a delicious sandwich, took a nap.
Oh god, dude, Rick, there's
yeah,
you can't get this anywhere else, dude.
yeah. Pretty chill day, pretty chill day. Not
There's
gonna
no other
lie,
place in the world where
yeah.
you can find one white, one black, talk about going to the gym, making a sandwich, and taking a nap.
Oh my God, what a life.
New Ricker and Bond, dude. Airhorn, airhorn,
Skin.
airhorn, airhorn. I guess
What
I
did you
could
do
play that.
today?
Yeah, you just literally nothing.
Nice, dude.
Literally nothing. What's new? What's exciting?
What's new?
Right now,
Okay,
without alienating your actual stay.
I have learned to make software
Oh, yeah.
on my 2 year vacation. Yes, now I'm not gonna say I'm good at it, but getting pretty nice
Okay.
at the coding. And let's be honest, AI has been a huge help.
Work.
Yeah, definitely seeing a glimpse of the future every time I, me and the AI get together and make some shit. So yeah, that's been exciting.
What
Other
have you
than
made?
that, what have I made? A lot of websites. Made a couple of or one website for a business, a local taco truck here in LA. Working on some this one thing that's like, I don't even know how to describe it. I'm just making it. It's just a form builder. Like if you want to make a form for your website and
Dope.
you like make it on the fucking platform. It gives you code, you put the code on your website, a form shows up, and then the data goes to the platform. You can view it.
Airtable.
Yeah, pretty much that.
Nice.
Google Sheets of sorts. What else? Yeah, pretty much been putting all my eggs into that the past year and a half or so.
Quick little nap. That's crazy.
Yeah.
Oh well.
A quick nap.
Just a few years ago.
Yeah, trying to fucking like make something that's just fucking awesome. I don't know. Or get a job with it. We'll see.
That too.
Yeah.
I had been playing with an idea of doing reaching out to people to bully my way into financial stuff. But I just wanted to give them like 7 questions instead of like a 30-minute Zoom interview. And I was doing that, and then Ricker and Bond Instagram is a nice leverage. So then I went back into Spotify, and there's like a blip sometimes of people listening. And there's about like an average of 15 to 30 people listening. So I was like, hey dude, we potting or what?
So you're just using me for career gain, is
Yeah,
what you're
dude.
saying. Got it.
And it makes
No,
me
no.
about new stuff.
No, a popular podcast can for sure
Not even
help.
popular. Like the 14K on Instagram is basically, although it's 9 now, but you know, that's neither here nor there.
I made a couple episodes of my tech podcast, beginning of the summer. Yeah, Processing Power.
Wow, dude.
And I discovered a technique that might help a little bit in terms of viewership. Basically, just like the most important, like simply just the most important topics that you're talking about, like just put them in the title, like the top three.
Yo,
So I
Philly
would put
D.
like, yeah, like literally like fucking Apple announces Apple Intelligence and OpenAI's fucking or NVIDIA stock goes wild or some bullshit.
Yeah.
And like something that people would look up like today. And then like usually on the first or second day it would have like a spike and then it would go
Our
down.
still our the biggest episode on this program is I've been working on the weekends like usual. So
Oh
it's
wow.
a bunch of people searching a Drake lyric into Spotify.
Damn.
Finding a Ricker and Bond pod. Also, Spotify analytics are even worse than Anchor were.
Really?
Be anything.
I was about to say, I feel like Spotify has improved on the
It's like
front end at least, but
I wanted to see some like length, unless I looked it up on a wrong, like on mobile and not on desktop, but it was the pits.
was bad.
Spotify has really big dick to the podcast industry. I'm surprised that Apple hasn't gone harder on like making Apple Music the place to upload your podcast or Apple Podcasts or whatever.
They tried TV. The podcast is, you know, you made the pod. You already made the name. You don't, they don't want to be greedy little pigs, dude.
Yeah, but I mean, there's so much money, like, for the first, like, for like the bigger ones, you know?
Yeah.
But like, I feel like they could be getting a slice of that.
At least upsell it into a bundle of Apple products.
Yeah, or fucking like,
Caller Daddy went to
be at least competing like for fucking, what?
Caller Daddy went to Sirius like 4 days ago.
I saw that for what, like 100 million?
I want to say 130.
That's wild. Now, see, Apple could have done that and been like, oh, this is an Apple podcast exclusive or whatever. They have the money.
Yeah. Caller Daddy Alex Cooper, 125 million deal with Sirius XM.
That's insane.
I think she might talk less about her vagina now and more just like talking to people. We also miss Hawk to a girl.
Oh, yeah. Is she still around?
No, she's gone. Sirius XM, dude.
Bro, I didn't know they had that kind of money still.
I mean, 125. How many years?
So is she like the new Howard Stern or something?
Yeah. She's a millennial Howard Stern for sure.
That's fucking crazy, bro. That's fucking serious cheddar.
Serious?
She started on Barstool.
Yeah, which is wild.
And she used to have a co-host, right? You think your co-host is happy?
Dude, the Sirius XM stock chart is absolutely horrid. It's literally a crypto. It started in 95. It's a 19, almost multi-decade crypto chart.
Better or worse than Intel stock right now?
I would say Intel might be better, dude. Let me see. It depends when you got it.
If you were holding Intel stock in 97, you'd have the same amount of money. Yeah,
97, a tiny bit better. just a
little bit.
$3.
Imagine if your fucking retirement was in Intel.
I bet a lot of people's were.
Yeah,
maybe not, because it's actually a really bad stock.
I was reading that a third of NVIDIA employees now have over $20 million in stocks.
I would, I believe, was it Uber or someone adjacent to Uber? See, I don't feel like it was Uber. Speaking of Uber, though, they also did kind of make a comeback, dude. 2018 Robinhood era, they were okay.
And Uber
did bad.
You're right. Uber did make a comeback. But like, if I remember correctly, it was because they invested in something that did well, not really because their core business was like making a lot of money. Which is interesting, because like, you would think Uber be profitable by now.
Yeah, we all thought so.
You got Waymo in San Diego?
Like car wise?
Like you can take it like an Uber?
I want to say no, but it could be true, but I'm also on their website and it says San Francisco, Phoenix, Los Angeles. So
yeah, they just opened it for everyone in LA, and I've used it once, but it doesn't come to where my place is. There's like a window in LA you can use it, which is a pretty good like chunk of LA, don't get me wrong, but just not where I live.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember who this freaking CEO was.
Dara?
No, not for that company. There was a headline of a CEO that in stocks fell, and he was like, yeah, I'm having trouble making ends meet. He had to like sell his mansion for 55 mil.
Damn.
Dang. I can't find it.
Maybe if he was better at his job, the stock would go up.
So I went into a Chipotle, right? Chipotle just recently swapped their CEO. He went over to Starbucks.
Yeah.
Apparently he is a go-to guy that makes money, at least stocks go up. Mr. Brian Nickel. I go into my quaint San Diego Chipotle at, maybe 4 p.m., 5 p.m. and they're just blaring Young Dolph from the
This was Chipotle.
Chipotle. They're playing 100 Rounds by Young Dolph, which I had to look up because the lyrics are 100 shots. How do you miss 100 shots? Let me look up these lyrics, dude.
Some Chipotles can be ghetto,
Well, I
for
mean,
real.
I'm not in the most ghetto of places in that I have ever lived.
The one downtown LA on fucking, what
It's
street is
nice.
that? Fucking Flower? Oh my God, that one
It's
is.
a nice time in there.
It's like, where's the regional manager? Like,
That's
come
what
on.
I say.
Can we get this place cleaned up? And the food tastes horrible.
I took a video of it playing just loud drill music, and I was like, one CEO change and these cats go wild
Bro,
in the kitchen.
I think it needs to be lower than the CEO. I think the fucking district manager, or because the fucking two blocks away is another Chipotle and it's
Oh,
phenomenal. Like,
really?
everyone there is respectful. Like,
That's funny.
fucking, I think it's just a manager issue. And the food tastes like way better. I don't get it. It's like, yo, you guys are so close to each other and
You
they're using the
know,
same supplier.
I'm fine with blaring of drill music as long as I get a nice bowl. I did get a nice bowl, but I'm not so sure that tourists that are frequenting San Diego want to hear 100 Shots by Young Dolph. I think he might be dead.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, maybe.
Young Dolph.
Yes, he's indeed dead. Rest in peace, rest in peace.
Damn, rest in peace, Young Dolph.
It's
Well, as long
Boeing,
as the
dude.
food was
Boeing's
good.
killing people and people who want to talk about people killing people, but I don't know anything about Boeing. I'm just a young man.
Yeah, what are your thoughts on that?
Hey, man, they're doing all right. Tell me.
It's like, if you don't want to ride a Boeing plane, like, you don't have much choice.
I haven't been on a plane in a minute, but you know.
The last plane I went on went to Hawaii in June.
Went to Ukraine and something, I don't know. They're saying, oh, you're went to Hawaii, which island?
Just good question. Maui.
Go to Waikiki for a homie, but
Yeah, I like fucking well, I used to want to live there, but I was there recently and I was like, you know, I feel like you can't really make a lot of money here. You know, I feel like if you
of
want to
course
make
you're
like some
expensive.
serious cheddar, you live in the Bay or New York.
Sure.
And then, like, to make like okay cheddar, you can like live in LA. But like the big fuck you money is in San Francisco, New York.
Did you have a lot of taxes?
A lot of taxes. Yes, quite. I was talking to my homie about fucking LA, and he's always bitching about LA taxes. And I'm like, bro, where else are you gonna fucking live? Like, where else are you going to go? Like, be for real.
Yeah, other places kind of suck.
Yeah. Like,
Once you
fucking, go to
hit the
Tucson?
bracket,
Jesus.
sure, but once you're just a young buck making things.
Fuck, I want to show you this fucking map. I don't even know where I
Sure,
found it, but
sure.
it was just a map of like,
Kids
I don't
living.
know. It was just like the fucking United States, and it showed like days with comfortable weather. And like 99% of the US was like, didn't have it for like more than
We
7 days.
also missed it has gotten just consensus by consensus everybody agrees it's a lot hotter in California.
Yeah.
San Diego has gotten like anomaly weather.
Fuck, I haven't been in the desert all summer.
You
Like,
got to go to the
like for fucking global warming, bro, like you gotta get it out of Palm Springs. Like,
You gotta go to AC, dude. Everybody in San Diego built houses and they're like, dude, it's gonna be 71 and breezy forever. Or at least
holy
40
shit.
years and I'll be dead. And they did die, and then everybody who's 35 now is like, yo, dude, we need some AC in these joints.
And easy. What's going on down there? Chill.
Just a bunch of biotech.
Nice.
That's also why I was reaching out to cats.
Biotech.
Yeah, it's a big biotech place. It's kind of the business popping down here, which is very difficult to get your head around unless you're a freaking chemist.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck biotech
Yeah, just people making like biology stuff.
is.
Ain't no
That
lily,
sounds
you know what I
expensive.
mean?
Ain't no young man's game. Ain't no only bachelor's degree game.
that's something you do for about 40 years, get a bunch of money in the bank, and then you're like, yo, do you want to like start a little research facility out in North Park?
There are a lot of fucking regular tech companies down there.
I'll see, but biotech is kind of the niche down here. And probably defense. A lot
Oh
of
yeah, probably get them out of defense.
it's making metal businesses.
I should get them out of tech in LA more than I actually thought for some reason.
Yeah, when you start to like look up stuff and you're trying to like network or like solicit yourself to people and you look up businesses and you're like, what is down here? La Jolla does have a lot of financial stuff, a lot of VCs, which is also my want to leverage people with a nice little small podcast.
Nice.
Clean up the Instagram a little bit. See what happens.
Nice, dude.
Did we learn any lessons from last time?
Maybe don't take a 2-year break.
I mean, consistency was never our downfall. We were always pretty consistent.
Yeah.
It's probably just the
Learn
operation.
any lessons from last time? What do you mean?
I don't know. To capitalize on a
Oh.
small network of stuff.
Focus on
I did write a thing.
tech and business, which I think we were already doing,
Yeah, we made that paper.
because that's where the fucking ad money is.
It's also what I'm interested in.
Fuck, I guess like
I think reaching out to more people. That's always been like the Trojan horse of podcasts.
podcast do you listen to right now? But like
I mean,
nothing.
the compound and friends, just financial professionals.
I see.
Listens to like Goldman Sachs Capital Flow podcast. I tried to listen to Rogan and Sandler and I couldn't get through it because it's on YouTube again. And I lasted like 1 minute.
Sandler?
Yeah.
He was on Rogan?
Rogan.
Oh, I didn't know that. Yeah, I haven't listened to Rogan in a minute. Who am I listening to now?
Apparently, it's still like
Ooh.
the top. I haven't looked.
Yeah, he's killing. Is he not with Spotify anymore?
Either he is not, or he was able to syndicate everywhere on Spotify. Because it wasn't on YouTube, and you might as well be on YouTube, dude. Come on, Eck, Daniel Eck.
On, Eck.
Get your head in the game, dude. Spotify was also a 2018 darling.
YouTube's the biggest streaming service in the world over Netflix,
YouTube's the
even.
best, dude. Jesus.
For TVs, for TVs.
Spotify making a generational, as in generational, in its stock's lifetime run. It's making its way back to its 2021. Just month after month of green.
Yeah, Spotify is doing surprisingly well. It's actually more popular than Apple Music on iPhones, if
I
you can believe it.
have seen that sentiment, and people using Spotify over Apple Music, I still don't get. I like Apple Music way more.
Yeah, I don't. It just sounds better.
I think the whole experience is better. And people are like,
Like,
Apple, the sentiment is Apple Music is for like olds.
it has to be fucking. Maybe it's podcasts and audiobooks that are like doing some of the heavy lifting. You think?
Audiobooks, I didn't think of.
But yeah, audiobooks aren't like
Does it have
a
everything
free.
on Spotify? All the books?
I think so, but you gotta be a premium
Yeah. Oh,
user.
okay. I didn't think about that. Maybe the
Yeah, but podcasts are free.
What's up with these
They,
Spotify financials? We can talk about
they, yeah,
it later
Spotify is doing fucking.
in about 8 minutes, but I am curious.
Spotify's doing well.
I want to see if it has green stuff. Profit margin, -4%. Market cap, big.
Big boo-boo.
No, market cap's fine. I mean, it's whatever. But profit margin is in the red. Income, net return on assets, institutional ownership 58%. Not my biggest. Not a big fan of that number for institutional ownership.
Oh, you want to talk about a stock that literally has been kicking ass that I thought would not kick ass?
Tell me.
Meta.
Meta has risen from the dead, all with Zuckerberg's jawline.
Yeah, I thought, yo, this metaverse thing is the nail in the coffin. I don't know how he can recover from this after like just the losses that he talked about and the fact that fucking crypto's crashing and no one gives a fuck about the metaverse, yada 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 yada. But Mark pulled a fucking, oh, not only that, fucking when Apple fucking fucked them with their ad thing,
Yeah.
like just killing their core business. I thought it's over, but Mark fucking did it. He used AI, apparently, and he like redid, well, not him, but Meta, like used AI to like recalibrate their like ad tool strategy so that ads are more effective for businesses, and that's just fucking killing it right now. Not only that, Instagram is fucking killing it in terms of numbers.
Instagram really is still a very big stalwart.
Yeah, apparently, like, what was the fucking stat? Like 65 or 75% of the globe uses one Meta platform every day.
And the WhatsApp is absolutely just killing everybody
Dest
everywhere.
destroying, fucking killing it.
Profit margin
But
28%, which is
and
a little
they
bit.
did that with laying off 30% of their employees. So they just said, we don't even need this many people and we make more money.
Classic, fire everybody.
Yeah. Yeah. So
Institutional
that's crazy.
75%. PR team was like, yo, we fired everybody. We're gonna get you a little bit jacked. We're gonna, shove you over to the UFC. You're gonna look a little bit cooler. And then once the final phase rolls in, our final phase for you, Mark, chain around the neck, dude. Necklace.
Yeah.
That
Mark, you're getting old, but you're still a young billionaire. We can still turn this around.
is gonna get our stock to the top, baby.
Yeah. Killing it. Fire everybody that made a day in the life video on TikTok about rolling to the office at 1 o'clock and leaving at three.
They set everybody up, bro. They set everybody up with that freaking COVID, little quick COVID jab. Everybody go home
Bruh.
and see what you really do.
If I do, imagine if I had learned to code in 2020 when I could have gotten a job by the end of that year. They were just handing jobs out.
Yeah, timing, dude. Timing is everything, man.
Yeah, bro, I was going through my LinkedIn. There was a message from 2020 from a Facebook recruiter, bro. I didn't even know how to code back then, bro.
Oof, dude. I mean,
Yeah, bro, I couldn't
you would have
even.
been probably fighting for your life at the 22 layoffs, but by that time, by
I
that
would have
time,
gotten laid off for sure, but it would have been
already
on the
all good,
resume.
dude. Freaking leverage
Yeah.
that joint.
Yeah. So
LOL.
I don't know. Hindsight's 2020.
Always.
No pun intended.
Why is that?
Because 2020, the year.
Yeah, that's when everybody's vision started. That's when the collective consciousness started.
Oh my God. Oh, Jesus Christ. Could have been anywhere. You're gonna make it 300 grand.
Meta made steep cuts in 2022, early 23. AI-driven improvements to the social media giants' recommendation system and ads platform. I will say I hadn't been on Meta for my ads personally for a minute, and I did it a couple weeks ago. I mean, everything was the same, but they did have some kind of like AI, whatever, whatever. I didn't go deep enough into my funnels or to see any difference, but
I'm banned from all Meta ad platforms. Yeah.
That's a is indeed a problem with stuff.
Yeah, they need to fix
Probably a great service to try to get people unbanned, but I'm pretty sure the unban process is not as lenient as people wish it would be.
if you can do it like effectively, I'm sure you can make bank.
Yeah.
Because like whole businesses rely on
Which is, yeah, it's just bum, dude. You just get banned. There's
Yeah,
that.
and you can't talk to anybody to help you.
Yeah.
It's just like, and you could just be clicking shit trying to figure it out.
Yeah. I
And
wonder
it's like bot alert.
if it's beneficial on the meta side. I would like to, say this out loud, that Meta is for sure Meta now. I will never call Twitter X out loud unless I'm saying it for efficiency.
Yeah, that was so bad.
But Meta is for sure Meta.
Bro, fuck. Why
I'll
do you do
give. I
that?
mean, when was Twitter X'd? 20.
About a year
Okay, I'll give it a few
ago.
years. Meta took me a few years, but like.
But like Meta's a better name, but like X is not a better name than Twitter.
It also has like a suite of stuff. And with Twitter, you're just referring to Twitter. With Facebook, it's like there was always an umbrella over it with like seven, eight different things.
Twitter was like a beloved global brand. That's like you stepping into Disney and changing it to Ricker. You know, like people be like, what?
Can't believe that the app profile, whatever you want to call it. What do you the app icon? He made it a freaking 2009 grunge logo.
It's
God dang, dude.
so ugly, bro.
Literally
Now, like,
spit on it.
when I w open it and the first thing I see is just hardcore pornography, I'm like, this is like fitting for
That's
the,
on you.
you
I
know.
did
Oh, no,
yesterday.
I curate it for sure. I curate
Well,
it for
I
sure.
will say,
But
if you curate your Twitter, it's very nice. I'm
you
I
mean my
don't
ex?
I will never I might say it in a text. One second.
Now you can't even say tweets.
Kind of get, but also like it's annoying. But it's also like a testament to people liking it because I don't know how many other products can change features every couple months and get away with it.
Because Instagram will like look different for different users.
Yeah.
So like for
Just
example,
constantly
fucking
A/B testing everything.
yeah, like everybody got the fucking AI search feature like months ago, and I just got that like this week.
Oh, really? 20,
Yeah.
20, 20 carousel posts and all that.
Yeah,
Not that
Jesus
much,
Christ. I fucking hate Instagram because it's fucking addicting. Like
yeah.
I know they're listening to me. I know they listen to my thoughts like somehow.
So I downloaded Blue Sky for the first time like 2 days ago or yesterday. Blue Sky is like, I'm pretty sure Jack's thing, or he liked it, but it's a federated Twitter knockoff. Talked about it about 3 years ago. Dang, did Presearch get rid of its Google joint? Oh man, shout out Presearch. Did you ever use Presearch?
Heard of it. What is pre-search?
We had the founder of Presearch on this very podcast. It's a search browser, not a browser, but a search engine. And I always just clicked it as an automatic thing to get its little token. And then I clicked Google right after. And I think they went away with that, which is probably good for them. But I use Blue.
Pre-search ran out of money, closed.
I mean, I'm using it, but I'm not sure how much money they have.
Oh, decentralized search engine.
Yeah. It gives you a little,
Oh, yeah.
it gives you a dopamine hit when you search and it gives you a token. I do like their ad platform business is kind of interesting. But you need people on it. I forget what that's called.
Customers.
What?
Need customers.
Yeah, the network effect is you need. And the same thing with Blue Sky, where I'm on Blue Sky and it's like, yo, like 10 posts, follow 10 people so we can know what you like. But it's like using the social media in the beginning of social media days when no one's on it. So like I want financial content and all the people I like to read financial content from are on Twitter.
Yeah.
So maybe they could do like a, they could scope your Twitter, scrape it for what you like and put that on Blue Sky. But it's kind of cool. But Twitter, same thing with Instagram, but Twitter I find is pretty nice with if you curate it, it serves you what you want.
Yeah, Twitter's still got all the people. I mean, like, my homie was trying to get me on what's someone called Mastodon.
Yeah.
And it is like cleaner, but you
So,
follow people, and then the last post was like 7 months ago, and it was like,
yeah,
okay,
same thing
back to
with those
Twitter.
threads. Serves you people that are posting on it, but it's not gonna, mostly it's not people you want to see.
Fuck Threads.
I see a pop up. It feeds me from the OIG.
They are force feeding me Threads, and I don't want it. Just give it up.
Go back to this Meta thing. Apple, screw them in
Meta.
2021. They shout out Axios. Dude, I feel like it's public, but do you know Axios, the like news publishing joint? Feel like someone, there's a story behind it that is interesting. Yeah, Cox bought it or something. But I'll just read what they say. Their ad business was focused on desktop until the smartphone became ubiquitous in 2014. I don't care. AI-driven content recommendations increase user engagement with the firm's products, driving more ad inventory, ad impressions across delivered Meta's family of apps, Facebook, Instagram, Messenger, WhatsApp, and Threads. I didn't even think about ads on Threads.
Yeah.
I'm not even sure I saw a Threads option on that.
Facebook ads or Instagram ads are effective.
They are indeed.
I'd be clicking.
People be clicking, dog.
I'd be clicking. When's the last time you clicked on an ad on Twitter?
Probably never.
Yeah, they're bad.
The Meta suite of ad impressions increased 10% year over year during the second quarter of 2024. The average price per ad, which was driven by demand, increased by 10% year over year. More than 50% of the content people see on Instagram is recommended by AI, the company announced in April. Reels alone make up around 50% of time spent on Instagram. I do be reeling. Shout out YouTube.
While we mentioned AI, what do you think about so AI in terms of valuation is something in the realms or in terms of spending, we're sitting in the realm of what? Or the entire fucking marketplace is what, $3 trillion, something crazy like that. Like most of it's Nvidia. Spending is projected to be into the hundreds of billions, just developing the technology to run these LLMs and stuff. But so far, AI as a product has not really made very much money.
Even
So,
with
bubble?
OpenAI or like,
Well, yeah, it's made the whole industry has made around $20 billion versus the $3 trillion that the industry is worth.
yeah, I mean, OpenAI is cool.
OpenAI is cool.
OpenAI is cool. There's probably about four other products that people would use. I mean, it'll be like anything else. It's probably super overheated as far as like, I mean, everybody's new VC project is a AI project instead of crypto. Like our last
Yeah.
episode, that will probably go away in a couple, I mean, either in a couple handful of years or when there's something else fun and new, which I don't see a lot of new fun things that will be as make a big of a splash sentiment wise as crypto and utility wise as AI.
I'm trying to find the product that's just gonna shit money using AI, because ChatGPT is the best digital product that I have ever used, but chatbots are
Also
a race
pretty
to the
small
bottom because they're
scale.
so cheap.
Yeah.
Yeah, to run the OpenAI API, you can print billions of words for pennies. So, how is this going to make trillions of dollars?
And it still also is like it'll just tell you what it wants, what you want.
Yeah. Now, I do see tremendous value in Like I don't think that like AI is going to take like developer jobs, but if you have a like let's say you have a team of 10 engineers, like 3 years ago they could only get the work done of 10 engineers, but now with AI they can get the work done of like 50
Yeah, that's
because
why
it just does so much of the hard work.
you said when you're looking for the product, I was like, I don't really think that, I mean, there probably will be a very cool product, but it's kind of just like, what's the internet product? It's like, this is kind of just a tool to leverage a business you already do and use less people.
Yeah. What was the fucking God damn it. I just saw like I want to say like the CEO of Netflix or something said something
Oh,
crazy.
it was Apple or Microsoft, and they said, look up if it's Microsoft, but they were like, we saved like 45,000
Yeah.
hours of time of work with AI.
Yeah, that's fucking nuts. And I was like, dude, I fucking get it. Because now, like for example, I'm fucking working with this taco truck for like making them a website, right? And they just sent me like this whole fucking list of things. Now I can literally like just screenshot the text message, give it to the AI and say, here, make these changes to the website. And it does it. And that would literally take me like at least 2, 3 hours to do everything. And I just gotta be like, okay, look good, change some things. It's fucking nuts.
Yeah, that's why I said it's like a leverage tool rather than like you're going to find the AI product.
Yeah,
The AI
fucking.
products are probably like, I would say the language models, but probably not.
Could you argue that the internet product is search, specifically Google?
In the past, I mean, if we look at the companies now, Google, Amazon, I mean, probably just the whole world of small businesses and medium businesses, but the biggest of the big, Amazon, Google Search, Google Ads, Amazon Web Services, still Amazon, but
Fuck.
yeah, so that's kind of the sprawling of mind web that people should probably think about, of like, it's probably just security, honestly. Security, like digital security, is probably a product that most people will benefit off of all this stuff. But
Yeah. Fucking everything is AWS security, pretty much,
yeah,
or Microsoft security, or Google
CyberStrike too, with
authentication.
CyberStrike.
Fucking Apple iCloud authentication is just AWS at the end of the day.
I'm a big dog. I was trying to look up, let's see what's in WisdomTree Cybersecurity Fund. Shadow WisdomTree. I'm a big dog. God, I forgot about that Future album, dude. Did you ever hear or listen to me here, Save Me by Future? It's a 2019er.
Probably.
He's a big dog. He can
Probably.
F bees out in France, dude. This is a weird holding list of holding by WisdomTree. I kind of want a Vanguard, but WisdomTree Cybersecurity Fund is HashiCorp, never heard of it. Commvault, never heard of it. Palo Alto, I think, had its run because of NVIDIA. Or it was like a meme stock or something. Let's see if I can get a Vanguard.
Damn. Remember Kathy?
Yeah.
She's going through it right now.
They bagged her, dude. They didn't like it.
Yeah. Oh, she fucking let go of NVIDIA too soon.
They didn't like it,
And
dude.
I'm
Vanguard.
fucking Vanguard. I
No, go ahead.
gonna say, I'm fucking, because she was like super into Tesla, and
I
I'm starting to lose
lost it.
faith.
I dropped it once it took its drop. It's way too
I
volatile.
don't own any Tesla.
Yeah.
I don't own like any stock in Tesla, but like I saw the vision more a couple of years ago, and now I'm just like, dude, they're too distracted.
I will bring this up because I didn't like this as well. And it might have been either Tesla's as a company, or it might have been the Elon's vision, but he was like, I'm pretty sure they wanted to bring that market to like a place where it's not super advantageous for Tesla as a whole, because they wanted more EV in the world. That was like a sentiment a couple years ago for a couple of seconds. And then they like don't know whether to do freaking luxury pricing or economy pricing. And then Elon as a freaking CEO isn't the highest and tightest, although he lands rockets in the water. But
Yeah, and it's like they're building fucking humanoid robots, and he's like, oh, but we are not a car company, we're an AI company. And it's like, bro, like you sell cars, you know, you
sounding
make your
very
money selling
VC,
cars.
sounding very VC.
Yeah, it's like please like make a decision. Because you got real people's money here tied up.
Once it see first bought it, it was like my kind of first foray into a nice company, because I bought First Solar in like the 2018 era, maybe even college era of 2017, 2016. And then they rolled it into Tesla. And then it was like making a dip back to that spot of like 2020, I guess that's my average price. But even just as a chart, it's not fun. I'm sure it will no doubt eventually like skyrocket and everybody will love it for a couple months, and if it can get back on like very nice track. But even that chart is like a trash chart. It looks like Disney.
I hope so, because they make a good product. They're just like fucking all
It's
over the
weird.
place.
Grab a Tim Cook. Man's can land rockets, but like, I don't know. Grab a suit.
You know what he is doing a good job on, though? Fucking Starlink.
Yeah. Lots of
Starlink is funding a good portion of SpaceX.
Mr. RFK. I was talking to my family, and they love a good Dem. And they're like, yeah, they're probably like, you probably like RFK, and I don't really, but he there's a clip of him talking on like steps, and he has his nice talking points of like whatever, but he's talking about like satellites that can just be plaguing the sky and watching every centimeter of the earth. And I was like, he had a good point about the satellites.
Definitely,
And the
yeah.
family member was also like, you probably like in that InfoWars guy too, don't you? And I was like, Mr. Jones does a lot of research.
Oh God.
He
Hitler, he had some good points.
brought up Sandy Hook. I was like, he had one wrong, okay? He got the hit. You're swinging for the fences, dude.
Damn.
Back to this EV, I was talking about kind of the EV space as a whole got kind of weird. And then this headline came up a couple days ago of China becoming the lead car supplier to Mexico, basically with BYD. And it could like backdoor itself into EV sales through the US via Mexico. So China just gets EV sales.
Interesting.
4.6 bill dollars worth of vehicles to the country into Mexico from China. Tesla rival BYD selling its Dolphin Mini in Mexico for around $21,000.
Isn't it crazy how we just trade? We're just like, hey, here's some stuff. Wait, did Mexico and China do a lot of business prior?
Not sure. I'll look it up for next episode, but
That seems like an unlikely like partnership. I
I
don't know
mean,
why.
I wouldn't be surprised if they just exported stuff out of China, 'cause I mean, China just exports out the yin yang, no pun
I
intended.
wouldn't be surprised if, like, whenever there is tariffs, Like the US says to Mexico, don't do business with China, or else we're going to
Yeah,
stop doing business with
which
you.
is was also interesting because Canada just like I'm pretty sure like 100% tariff on Chinese stuff, but like, dang dude, cheap EV cars half the price of Tesla. Also, BYD has a pretty okay like sentiment brand wise. Flooding into Mexico from China is not exactly the best safe business strategy from the US. Yeah, and there was something about these trade agreements. I forget what Trumpito did and what he wanted with Mexico, but free trade access is part of the United States Mexico Canada agreement, USMCA, revised iteration of NAFTA, which people seem to remember, that removed tariffs on many goods traded between the North American countries starting in 2018. Yeah, so I'll probably write a piece about this and kind of go into more, and I'll bring back some insights because it's quite interesting. You got some Chinese stuff in North Africa, Chinese stuff in Mexico, as far as trade wars go. They're encroaching.
Jesus. Who's winning the election?
I don't know. It's probably a freaking toss-up.
Honestly, it's a toss-up.
I'd be good off of another Trumpito, but I don't want people to freaking war with the people inside of US.
I'm kind of like.
As long as everybody's cool, just like be nice for like 2 years, and then we can get some whoever's in will be okay.
Kind of don't really care who's president.
I just don't want people to freaking civil war each other.
There's gonna be plenty of that. No
Just,
matter who wins, there's gonna be
the
plenty
first
of.
couple months, you go out and get your flags. Come on, just, do your US stuff. Everybody, it's a US
Board up
tradition.
your
It's
businesses,
a US
board up your
tradition to go
windows.
out, dude. There'll be one, a few banks on fire. It's, that's run-of-the-mill stuff. We do that. We do that now, then football season will come back or something, and then they'll forget about it. And just, we got enough external things. Everybody just be cool inside of the in the borders, eh? No matter if you're walled up or not, you know
What a great year for AI to get good.
what I mean?
For AI to just become
Being trained up
indistinguishable
all of
from
these freaking
humans.
jamokes on the internet in comments, dude. This is why you still need some freaking natural writers to get some nice some training off.
Oh, I was talking about AI video. Like, why is it so good this year?
Oh, I wonder. I wonder why
Oh.
2023 is why the nascent technology that has not been nascent for decades hits the retail.
You've seen
Speaking of
Sora, right?
the video stuff. Is that OpenAI or someone else?
That's OpenAI, but it's not out yet. But it made Tyler Perry cancel a
Yeah, I was gonna
billion-dollar
say,
studio project.
give it to Mr. Perry. Speaking of, this is hot off the presses from our friends over at PYMNTS, known as payments.com. Friend of the pod, everybody knows. Apple considers investing in OpenAI. Apple reportedly in talks to invest in OpenAI, which became the first official partner for Apple Intelligence in June. Which has Apple Intelligence been rolled out anywhere, or just new phones in like just 2 years?
No, it's not out yet. I don't think it'll be out until after the new phone comes out.
People will love it, dude. If we didn't say this on the pod, we said it to each other that, or I've said it to myself that Apple comes in as always. Handful, fistful of years later after a nice technology, plug it into a phone and everybody loves it a lot more.
And they get it for free. They get fucking OpenAI a taste of crack, and they say, "Hey, you want more of this? You want more of this, little buddy? Now you pay us $20 billion a year, and your fucking API can be on every iPhone in the world, just like they did with Google and Safari."
Which also is being under the gun of some laws, I think, right now.
Oh
Oh,
yeah, well they can't. Apparently, they can't do it in Europe. unfortunately.
Europe
So
always had
sucks for them.
Europe always had a weird digital ad thing, dude.
But let's call OpenAI by its real name, Microsoft AI, because Microsoft controls that bitch for
Microsoft.
sure.
Everybody knows Microsoft is nice. The Apple investment would be part of a funding round that would value OpenAI at over 100 billion. The
How
Wall
much more
Street.
money do they
Dude,
need?
they are going hard.
Have you seen those videos of fucking Sam Altman driving like the most fucking rarest one of one? I don't know shit about cars, but it looks fucking awesome. He's
No.
just zipping around fucking, and then he just gets out, this little fucking skinny guy. It
Oh,
looks fucking sick.
so
He's a robot for sure.
he's the next Mark, you know. He's
Have
the
you heard him talk? Have you heard his seen his thing with Lex Fridman?
no.
Like fucking Lex will
Talk like
make
Mark in
like
2013.
Lex worse. Like Mark was just awkward. Like this guy's not awkward. Like he like on like he like genuinely doesn't have emotions. Like Lex will try to make like a joke.
Yeah.
Like just like a lighthearted joke and fucking the guy won't even flinch. He'll be like, okay. Anyway.
He probably has the
Yeah,
world's
so
most freaking. He's probably so anxious right now, dude.
he's bro, that guy is like he fucking, I've never gotten serial killer vibes more than
He's
anyone,
probably,
but
if he's just, if he, you know, let's give everybody a benefit of the doubt that they are humans. He's probably just so scared for life. For
oh
future,
yeah, he sleeps with a loaded gun
continue
for
it
sure.
for his
Is he gay?
security, for freaking digital security, bro.
Sam Altman gay.
But
Yeah, he is gay.
ChatGPT, is he actually?
Yeah, I knew there was something off about
We're
him.
back. Rick and Bond, everybody.
Ricker and Bob.
Apple and Nvidia talks to invest in OpenAI. Investment will be part of the next fundraising round. Would value ChatGPT, it says in Wall Street Journal, as above 100 billion.
I gotta know what kind of guy Sam Altman's into.
We had
Even the like tiny little
one of the greatest segments
like
in on history was gay neighbor segment. I'll try to look it up or have AI look, but gay neighbor segment was a great bit. Wall Street Journal reported Wednesday, which is yesterday. It is August 29th, 2024 right now. The venture capital firm Thrive Capital is leading the round, which is interesting if it's more than freaking Apple and Nvidia. Total of several $1 billion, and Microsoft is expected to participate. It is not known how much Apple, Nvidia, or Microsoft will invest into OpenAI this round. To date, Microsoft has been the primary strategic investor in OpenAI. It owns a 49% share of the AI startup's profits after investing 13 billion, which I think is hella
bro.
low. Excuse my lack of knowledge if it's not, but
Is in
yeah.
like the grand scheme of things. It's already fucking made 20 billion back for like the
OpenSea valued at
industry.
13 billion in 2022. Christ and crackers.
Yeah, now it has to be close to 100 if
So
fucking Nvidia
a
itself
third.
is worth how much?
Let's see. I don't know a lot. So a $13 billion round in 2019. 5 years later, 100 bill. It's a pretty good multiple.
Also, NVIDIA needs to be watching its back too, because NVIDIA's biggest customers are Amazon, Meta, Google, and Microsoft. And I know for a fact that those companies don't like to share. So they could be making their own stuff right now. So they can say, bye bye, NVIDIA, you know, and then
Sure.
NVIDIA's fucked.
I mean, the boys have played nice in the past. I'm sure everybody wants they want everybody to think that they hate each other, but you know, Google, Microsoft, Apple all have some nice
Fuck.
strategic handshakes with each other.
Because fucking, how much do you think they're paying for these chips?
Lot, probably. I don't know.
Probably an arm and a leg. They can just make their own.
That's
But
a
like the who's benefiting most from this is Apple, because they don't have to spend any money on AI. They can just say,
yeah.
hey, can we use our iPhones and
It's a
we'll
little
make it
bit
look pretty.
of a classic acquisition in the past.
What's interesting though is that Apple's actually getting into this funding round because it seems a little bit heated, like you said. So they must be like, yo, this is just the beginning. There's way more upside here.
Yeah, they probably, I mean, was there anybody else in the 2019 round besides Microsoft?
I don't know. Fucking
I'm trying to read
Elon.
it. It's interesting that whoever Thrive Capital is was mentioned in this, but yeah, if so, I mean, it's probably just a play on like this is Microsoft encroaching on some stuff, and we want to be close to it. That's interesting. It's very interesting. I'll come back next episode as well with some, if you can find any like analogs to it, or some comparable stuff.
Yeah.
I've never
Also, do some
heard of a
research because
big
this is
headline
interesting.
of like the top companies investing in a big, top of the bubble sentiment company. Like, when's the last time you
And
heard of a Microsoft Apple investment in headlines? Maybe it's just because it is OpenAI, but.
well, I'm pretty sure like Google and Microsoft invested in Uber, like in the early days and stuff like that.
Interesting.
But what's interesting about this is like, one, it's already like not fully funded, but pretty funded. And two, there's a bunch of fucking antitrust shit here. Because
Yeah.
like a lot of the big companies, like these CEOs are sitting on each other's boards,
Yeah.
which is like pretty illegal.
Well, that's probably, part of the reason why they're also getting in, but I mean,
How do I get money from this?
Microsoft. Have a nice position in Microsoft over the next 10 years. Dude, my iCloud is messing up. Anyways, we can wrap it up. A little bit of a
Ricker and
2 year
Bond.
siesta, dude. Peter, it's all for you, pal. Thanks for listening this far.
I was such a young man back then. My goodness.
I have some tangible growth in some areas, but it's very concentrated. And basically everywhere else, there has been kind of just stagnation somewhat. But
Did you learn?
I have prepared.
Well, you're not 30 yet, so we're
Dude, something you
we
say
got
like
some
that,
playtime.
you wake up another Rick and Bond episode, it's 30. But execution and
Fuck,
momentum
dude.
is key. This is also kind of why I wanted to pod again because I want to talk to other business owners. It's always fun.
Yeah, it's always fun. We still got a long road ahead. Unless we die tonight, but hopefully not.
Could always, dude. Could always. And if I do die tonight, at least I had a pod. I guess I have to publish it before that. But
Yeah,
yeah,
death.
time moves on. Family's getting a little older.
Yeah, they are.
Cousins
Holy
have kids.
shit. Fuck. Any kids for you? Popping any out?
I left them years ago. They're doing all right.
Those fucking any kids.
I
Jesus
might
Christ.
I might have a LA excursion coming up, so we'll make sure to be quick with it.
Sweet, dude. I'll be here in the greatest city on earth.
It's nice. This
The greatest city on earth.
is cool for sure, dog. Like,
Definitely come while it's clean, because they're cleaning it for the
oh, dude,
Olympics. It's
oh,
looking good.
forgot about all the future Olympics. We had some past Olympics on the mind, but yeah, dude,
Yeah.
homies whip some tents out of the sidewalks, some greenery over there at Echo, not Echo Park, at a Expo Park.
Oh, it's gonna be nice over there for sure. I used to work over there. They're fucking.
Expo is, it, I mean, it was always not. A nice block. There's always nice blocks or two in downtown LA.
Apparently, they're fucking making the pool even bigger because it's like too small right now. Yeah, they have a, like
The
an
USA
Olympic
pool?
size. Well, I guess it's not Olympic size anymore. No, there's a fucking pool next to, like, an Olympic pool next to the stadium from the first Olympics in the 80s.
Well,
Yeah, so
I'll probably pop over there for the World Cup as well too.
that.
It's in like
When is that?
26 or 28.
Oh,
Just
that'll be fun. Hopefully, the Lucas Museum is finally open.
the what?
The Lucas Museum.
What is that?
That's the fucking. Remember, were they doing the construction with Adobe? That big construction next to the museum.
I don't even know what museum you're talking about. Oh, like the dinosaur museum.
Natural history.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's like this fucking big fucking. It looks like a spaceship, and it's the fucking George Lucas Art Museum, and they've been building it for like 10 years, and it looks
I think
fucking
they
sick.
did they not like break ground on it in like when we were there?
I think they did, but it just didn't look anything like it does now.
I mean, it was
Like, it
out
was probably just
there.
dirt and shit.
Yeah.
But, like, if you look at pictures of it now, it looks fucking like crazy.
Shout out Miss
And
Katie.
it'll. Fuck, Miss Katie. Oh, Jesus Christ. I drive by there. Dude, I don't know if you've been over there recently, but there's a fucking huge ass apartment across the street. A building.
behind Miss Katie's.
Yeah.
Yeah, you said that last time.
I was like,
Oh yeah, dude.
what are they doing to my home?
Cats have been plotting on that since about 2012.
What are they doing to my home,
Oh
bro? I
man.
used to run these streets.
I used to run away at these streets. I
Oh
used
God,
to
this
stay
fucking
inside and
Ralph's.
watch the streets from the
I fucking went into that Ralph's. I got like a whiff of nostalgia.
window.
I was like, fuck this Ralph's. It's too crowded, dude.
Okay. Thanks for listening. Welcome back. We'll grab some AI freaking websites to make some clips.
Yeah,
Pop
your
them up
two
on
favorite
IG,
gay
man.
uncles are back.
Pop them up on YouTube, probably. TikTok, maybe. Did TikTok not exist, or did I just not go hard on it?
TikTok definitely existed. I pretty much just like abandoned my TikTok fandom.
Hey man, sometimes
I
we abandon things.
could be making like 60 grand a month right now.
TikTok's going to freaking e-commerce about it, but you know, e-commerce is also porn.
I just used to open TikTok and just get sad. I'd be like, bro, I hate this shit. I hate this platform.
Bro, the Chinese wrapped interfaces always have like a veil of like Chinese doing a US app. Like
Bro, it's
I
just
went
too
on
much shit
People.
on the screen. Looks like a
Yeah, dude.
casino.
It's a lot. It's like it would be cool maybe, and maybe I'll give them the advantage of they thought about this. They probably didn't. It would look dope from an AR perspective. If this was on goggles and you were like walking into a room, it would be a cool casino, but like it is so much stuff. But that's probably what I mean, they're used to all the pop-ups and stuff, but it's you can always tell this is some Chinese interface.
WeChat looking ass.
Yeah.
I've never met anyone that worked at TikTok that like
I
had a
was
good thing
about
to
to work
say
for
about.
ByteDance in like 2018.
Really?
Yeah.
Was
2017.
ByteDance even a thing? Was TikTok out in 2018?
It
Or was it
was
Musical.ly or
probably still
something?
Musical.ly, and they're probably transitioning.
It's crazy how
Thanks for
fast this
listening,
shit
everybody.
moves.
Rick and Bond on podcast everywhere. Sending DMs,
Hell yeah.
sending questions. We're here, the best podcast. No one's ever said that.
In the world.
Always have been. You can't come back
Yes.
from a 2 year hiatus and still be on top like we can.
You've been with us since 2018.
Peter's gonna
We
be
never left you.
He's gonna be
He's gonna
so.
get that fucking notification. He's gonna be like, fuck.
These
He's like,
nerds.
these super old teens.
That tagline is gone now, but
Oh man, we need to make a new cover for sure.
yeah, I definitely thought about that when I texted. I'll get a nice I'll put on a collared shirt and give a PSD of my face and my body.
Yeah.
Grab a
We
suit.
gotta make it look good.
Okay,
It's
thanks for
just
listening,
AI,
everybody.
some fucking stuff on Tuesday. Yeah. Okay, see you
Sort of
next week.
not gonna AI the face, but here we go.